Welcome to 558 Parkside Tech, where we talk about tech's past, present, and the future of tech. I'm your tech plug, Mike, as always kicking you the ism when it comes to technology. Today we're talking about polymorphism and its importance to object-oriented programming. So all you 558ers, future tech creators, let's get into it right after this. 558 Parkside Tech in effect. Today we're talking about object-oriented programming, and in particular polymorphism. But before we start, let's do a little recap. You see, there are four components of object-oriented programming, and for people to remember it, I always tell them to remember API, which is the easiest way to remember the four pillars in case you're in an interview and they ask you that question and you're trying to remember it. Just remember API and make it out from there. And that is A for abstraction, P for polymorphism, I for inheritance, and E for encapsulation. Today we're going to look at a program that deals with that and how to create polymorphism. But I'm showing you here in a UML diagram. If you watch my UML diagram video, it explains the purpose. But here the purpose of a UML class diagram is to kind of lay your ideas down before you start coding, so that maybe somebody more senior or another developer can look at what you're about to create and see if it makes sense. So here I'm showing you that we're going to create a class, okay, called Master Bedroom Mom. And these are the strings that are actually in it. You have color room, you have bed size, nightstands, television, etc. You have one method here called stuff, okay? And I'm also showing you that you have a daughter and brother class, which are gonna be called derived classes. So you'll hear these terms more as we start looking at code. But I want you to be able to look at a UML diagram and be able to decipher what you're gonna have to write as code. So let's get to it. Let's take a look at some code. So if you've been following along in my series for object-oriented programming, this is the inheritance program that we wrote previously. So let's do a quick review before we add polymorphism to it, which is real simple. So here we have a master bedroom mom class, which we're calling the base class. So that's a new term. If you're new to programming, it's a base class. All right. And then we have these variables or fields and kind of hard coded some values in them. So we have a public string, color room, public string bed size, public string nightstand, and a public string television. Now, if you notice how I've written it, this is something that when I first started learning the code, I did a horrible job of. That is pretty much, if you're writing C# code, there's a style. And so if you look at the style of how I've written this is called color room, right? But the R is capitalized. This is called camel case, and you'll see it all through any enterprise that has standards for their code. 9 times out of 10, they're gonna ask you to do camel case. So now you know what that is right off the bat. All right, so now we have this class and we have these variables and we have this method. And all I'm doing is doing a write to console, and you'll see what that means in a minute. And in that console write line, I'm saying one, master bedroom is for mom. I'm putting one and I'm throwing a bunch of J's just so you can see it. So that's the base class. Now, when we do this symbol here, this colon, that's inheritance. So what we're saying is we want the daughter to inherit from the master bedroom mom class, okay? And these, if you see here, this green, these slashes, that's how you denote comments. So if you're putting comments in your code, that's how you would do it, all right? So let me slide down a little bit here. So you have the daughter class, which we call a derived class. We also have a brother class. It also inherits from the mother bedroom class. All right, so they're both are gonna inherit. Now, each one of these classes have their own console write line, but there's a trick I'm gonna show you in a second. What happens to this in a second? So if we were to run this code, now remember what inheritance is all about. I started off with that because I think that's the easiest for people to remember because it makes sense in everyday life. If you have a parent, 9 times out of 10, you'll inherit their house or their car or whatever else. A friend of mine said, the only thing his daughter's gonna inherit is the condiments in his pantry, which is probably ridiculous. So anyway, so here that would make sense to you. So inheritance is kind of straightforward, But now let's run it and see what happens, okay? So I'm gonna go up here. I'm gonna go up here and I'm just gonna hit F5. You can do F5 where you can just hit this button which says start debugging, okay? And it's actually gonna run. All right. So now if you look at this, if you look at what we have here, right? Okay. Now this is the console. So it wrote to the console, all right? And it says here, you see this console write line, one master bedroom is for mom? There it is right there, because we wrote to the console. But then we see it again, and we see it again. Why? Because the daughter inherited from the master bedroom mom class, as well as the brother. So since they both inherited from it, they ended with the exact same thing. Now, the trick I mentioned to you is because the methods are the same name. So it's going to inherit whatever came from the base class, or in this case, the mother master bedroom class. So I hope you understand that. That's inheritance, which makes sense. And if you're not talking about code, if mom had a striped bedroom set and you inherited it, you get a striped bedroom set. So now how in code do we do polymorphism? This is how we do it. It's real simple. We go into the base class, okay, here, and we call it virtual, okay? So we make the base class method virtual. Now, I hope you understand what a method is. It's where all the work happens. If you wanna remember that, that's simple enough. It's where all the work happens, all right? So then we got a method here for this base class, and then we come down to the method of the derived classes or the daughter class, and we override it. Okay? And we can do the same thing for the brother's class method. All right? We override that as well. Okay? So what did we do? We just did three things and we're creating polymorphism. We're making the base class method virtual. We're making the derived class methods override. Okay. Now let's run it. All right. Let me just share this with you. You could either build a program, which is, if you're coming from the mainframe, it's compile. Okay. We can either build a program, which is compiling it. All right. Okay, and if you can see, if you look down here, there are no issues found. So if I had some bad code or something, there would be an error here I'd have to fix. You're gonna see a lot of errors, so you'll get used to this area, all right? So now I'm actually gonna run it, okay? When I run it, you're gonna see something a little different. See, now, they still inherit from the mother or the master bedroom mom's class, but since we overwrote it, now you see what was in the daughter console. Daughter loves hookah, brother loves football. So now you see, I'm just gonna move this over to the right. Now you see that this daughter, which had this console write line, is actually being written. It isn't just inheriting from here, it's actually because this method, the base class method, is virtual, we're able to override it. So it's almost like if you inherited something from your parents, just to give you a layman's example. You inherit that striped bedroom set, but now you're able to change the color of it. And how you do that in code with polymorphism is by first having inheritance, second, making the base class virtual, and third, doing the override on all the derived classes, all right? So in conclusion, you saw in action how polymorphism works. The word poly, if you break it up, polymorphism, it would be poly means many, morphism means to change. And so to accomplish polymorphism, the main thing you have to remember is you have to make the base class virtual. And then you have to do an override keyword for the derived class methods. Okay? Well, thank you for joining me today, and I hope this will continue your journey in learning tech and that you understand a little bit more about polymorphism and its importance in object-oriented programming. As always, continue to be better than your best excuse and continue to learn tech. Also, for those that keep asking about Patreon, I keep getting more emails about Patreon, about Cash App and all that. I don't have any of that. This is a free platform. If you want to donate anything, you can go to 558 Parkside Tech and hit the donate button. So I'll see you next week, where we go into abstraction as well as encapsulation and complete the series of object-oriented programming. Once again, take it easy. Peace. Yeah, 558 Parkside Tech in effect, that tech, 558 Parkside Tech in effect, tap in the future, let me introduce ya, 558 Parkside Tech, about to school ya, 558 Parkside Tech in effect, that 558 Parkside Tech in effect, that tech, 558 Parkside Tech in effect, that Parkside.